Good morning, everybody, and welcome to my talk. My name is Janki Chhatbar, and I work as software engineer at Red Hat. I contribute to OpenStack and OpenDaylight software. Those are open source projects. OpenStack is what I'll be talking about in details, and OpenDaylight is a software-defined networking controller. That's my Twitter handle and my email ID. Running OpenStack in containers, that's the topic of my talk today. What it means is all the OpenStack services, the services we'll be looking at in later, all the services are run inside the containers and not as systemd processes on the host itself. So how many here knows what is OpenStack or have heard it, deployed it, contributed to it, used it? Okay. Its official page says it's a cloud operating system. Cloud is a collection of servers. An operating system is a software that manages the resources on those servers. It's governed by OpenStack Foundation. The source code is available on GitHub. The bugs are filed at Launchpad, and code review happens on Gerrit. Its 17th release was released on 28th February. It's named Quince. The next release is named Rocky. The releases are named alphabetically. It falls into the cloud computing model of providing infrastructure as a service. The other two models are platform as a service and software as a service. We'll see what these cloud computing models means. These are classified based on the resources that the service provider has to manage. To get a better understanding, we'll try an analogy with eating a pizza. So on-premise infrastructure is right now what the industry is. Everybody has their own servers, they manage their own hardware, operating systems, virtualization, networking, storage, application. It's like making a pizza at home, right from kneading the dough to baking it to setting the table, cleaning the dishes later on. Infrastructure as a service is when you get a ready-made infrastructure, you get servers ready, deployed, the networking among the servers is taken care of by the service provider. You just need to install the OS of your choice and run an application on it. It's similar to buying a frozen pizza and baking it at home. Examples are OpenStack, of course, Azure, Microsoft Azure, and AWS, Amazon Web Services. The next computing model is platform as a service, where you just need to take care of your application and data. The rest of the layers, the whole of the stack is managed by service provider. This is like getting a pizza delivered at home. You just need to worry about the tables and the plates. Examples, Google App Engine and OpenShift. The third model is software as a service, where you do not have to manage anything at all. You just need to use the whole stack for whatever purpose you need. The whole of the stack is then managed by service provider. This is like dining out. Just go to the restaurant, order a pizza, enjoy, and come back. Example is Gmail. Google takes care of hosting the Gmail servers, ensuring that the mails are getting delivered. You just need to write a mail and send it. OpenStack is a collection of projects. These are few of them. For example, Nova is a compute service which takes care of spawning a VM. Ironic is for bare metal services, which manages the bare metal servers connected to the cloud. Swift and Cinder are for storage. Glance is used to store operating systems. These operating systems are then used for while spawning the VMs. Neutron is for networking. Heat is an orchestrator. Horizon provides UI. Kolla is for providing OpenStack container services. This we'll again see later in much detail. And TripleO is the installer. This is what I'll be talking about. So TripleO is an OpenStack installer. The other two are DevStack and PackStack. TripleO means OpenStack on top of OpenStack. It first deploys a cloud called Undercloud. Undercloud then goes on and deploys another OpenStack cloud, which is called Overcloud. And this Overcloud is the OpenStack cloud that is actually accessible for to the users. That is where the end user spawns their VMs. It provides CLI and UI for deployment. And from Pike release, that was the one before Queens, 6-7 months back, from Pike release, TripleO also has a support for container deployment of Overcloud. So this is the deployment architecture. There's the Undercloud, which has the services like Nova, Neutron, Swift, Heat, Ironic. These are the few basic necessary services. Rest you can have as and when your use case needs. The Undercloud then goes on and deploys Overcloud. Overcloud generally contains two nodes. Nodes, when I say here, generally means hardware servers. The Overcloud controller node and Overcloud compute node, these are the generally these are the names that are given. Two nodes is a very common deployment architecture. If you want an HA, you can also specify that I need a controller HA. You can also increase the number of compute nodes that you need. TripleO itself, again, is a collection of different projects that work together to provide a fully functional and deployed cloud. There's a TripleO client which provides CLIs for deployment, update, and upgrade. TripleO Common is where the deployment logic is actually implemented. It serves as a server to the TripleO client. TripleO Heat Templates is a collection of YAML files that has information about the deployment architecture, that has information about how the services will be deployed, on which node which service will be deployed. Like I said before, if you want to have, say, an HA deployment, there is a dedicated TripleO Heat Template YAML file in the source code where which says that please deploy my controller in HA mode. Puppet TripleO is a collection of Puppet manifests that describes how the services will be configured on the nodes, on the compute and controller nodes, Overcloud nodes. And TripleO Upgrades manages the upgrade of cloud from one major release to the next major release. Apart from TripleO, another OpenStack projects that help are Ironic. Ironic will go and configure the Overcloud node servers. Heat then creates a stack for the resource stacks for the cloud. Ansible configures the servers and the services. Puppet again configures the services inside. Mistral and Zakar, these are the Mistral is actually actioned. So Mistral actually divides the action into different tasks and then it executes those. And Zakar is the messaging service between OpenStack components. Kolla provides Docker images, Docker files for all OpenStack services to be containerized. So what we have learned so far is there's an Undercloud OpenStack cloud which goes on deploys Overcloud. Overcloud generally has two nodes, a controller node and compute node. Controller node will have Nova, Neutron, Glance, Keystone, Horizon, Heat, Celiometer, any service that you want. And Overcloud Compute generally has Nova Compute service, which is important for spawning a VM. The architecture deployment is defined in the Heat template. Ironic configures the controller and compute nodes. Ansible, again, manages the steps and configures the nodes. Heat creates the necessary resources, and Puppet configures the individual services running on those nodes. What are containers? So far, what we have seen is the services are run as systemd processes on the controller and compute nodes. Now we want the same services to run as containers on the controller and the compute nodes. So containers long back, there was a time where a dedicated hardware was used for an application. So the problem here was underutilization of the resources. So we moved to using VMs. Now again, these they are very heavyweight. They need each individual OSs. They take space. So we moved to using containers. These are lightweight. They share the host OS itself. They don't need much time to boot up. With all these advantages of containers, OpenStack also, you know, moved to containerized deployment. Few terminologies in regards with containers. It first one is Dockerfile. Dockerfile is a file which has a set of commands that says what my Docker container will be, what service it will run, when it will run, what port it will run on, what will be the base OS for the container. Docker image. A Docker image is a ready-made, it's a turned off instance of a container, you can say. The process of a Docker image is actually the Docker container. And Docker Hub is a registry. Registry is a place where you can push all your Docker images. It has the images for different OSs, for different applications, different services stored, and that registry is called a Docker Hub. For OpenStack, there is a dedicated project called Kolla, which provides Docker files for all the services. The Docker file is locally editable and it can be locally built. The Docker images are built by TripleO CI. These images are then pushed to Docker Hub, and these images can also be customized for each OS. You can specify for what host OS you want the Docker image for. You can also specify how to run the packages that how to install the services that are run inside the container. Punch is another project in OpenStack that manages the life cycle of a container. The Punch takes input, the heat template as an input, it's a YAML file as an input, and starts a Docker container based on the definition as given in the heat template. All the Docker containers use host networking, which means that they'll be running on the same port as the actual host is running on. They are configured to restart the service whenever the service fails. Whenever a service running inside the container fails, the container automatically restarts. All this definition is prescribed in the heat template. There is a specific Docker underscore config section in the TripleO heat template that will specify all these details. I have a small demo. So here I am already inside undercloud, as you can see via SSH. The user is stack user. I sourced a stack RC file which has the username and password and all the accessible credentials to access the undercloud. As you can see, there are too many OpenStack services. Some of them are enabled because you actually want that service to run on the controller node, on the undercloud node, sorry. The others are disabled because you do not basically need them. There's a specific service, Nova API service, which actually takes care of spawning VMs on the node. As we saw earlier, the service was running because this is an undercloud node. OpenStack server list is again one of the commands which will list all the VMs that are running right now. So as you can see here, I have two compute nodes and one controller node. These three nodes are the overcloud actually, and I'm logging in SSH into the overcloud controller node. You can see the IP from there. On the controller node, when you say list the systemctl processes and grab on OpenStack, you'll see all of these are disabled. Because this is a containerized deployment, we are not running the services as systemctl. Instead, even the OpenStack Nova API service is disabled. These are the many OpenStack service containers that are running on overcloud node. See, the Nova API service is running as a container and it was not running as systemctl process. It was disabled as we saw earlier. So what we have established so far, again the undercloud is the same, overcloud controller and compute nodes are same, all the projects are same. Heat template that defines the deployment architecture, that defines the nature of the service, that defines what service will run on what node. Ironic configures these two compute and controller nodes. Ansible configures these nodes. Heat creates the necessary resources. Puppet configures individual services inside. Another utility called Ponch was introduced, which will manage the containers. And individual OpenStack services are running inside these containers. So how Ponch is beneficial here is that, first of all, it takes YAML files as an input. So replacement of any YAML file becomes very easy. Second, the containers are managed statelessly. They are all the containers are given a particular tag. There are few tags defined. They are given tags, and based on the tags, the lifecycle of the containers is managed. Based on the tag, if suppose there is a tag which says validation, during deployment at the validation step, all the containers would be started. So suppose. I'll leave it an open question to for all of us to think how easy it would be to upgrade from one version, OpenStack major version, to another OpenStack major version when the services are running on containers, and how easy it would be to move from development to production. Questions? Yes. Sorry?
Okay, thank you for your presentation. And I have a question that you said that if you run in OpenStack in container, you can easily upgrade, right? So how about the downtime we have? Is there any downtime?
There would be a downtime of about 5 minutes. 5 minutes is a very high limit that I'm saying. It depends on how fast the network connectivity you have, how fast your deployment is able to fetch the Docker images from your registry. Or if you want to still make it faster, TripleO also provides a local registry. You can push your images to the local registry before deployment, so that during deploy, this all happens runtime. So during deployment, when the image is pulled, it is pulled from Docker local registry and not from the Docker hub, which takes time.
Does anyone have any other questions? Yeah.
Sorry. Any rollback solution for the fail during the upgrade process?
What happens if it fails during upgrade?
I mean some rollback solution. If the rollback process is failed.
Sorry?
Is there any roll back solution? You mean the roll back solution? You know your roll back solution? I mean, is there any backup?
Okay, roll back. Yes. Oh, so whenever an upgrade fails.
Do you mind rephrasing the question?
Yeah, sure. So basically, he's asking what happens if the upgrade fails. Upgrade fails in the sense, which means your cloud is not upgraded. You are still on the same version. So your original version cloud is still running. It's not gone anywhere. There's no rollback because the upgrade does not happen in steps. It happens a whole complete process. So if a process stops somewhere, fails somewhere, you are still at the original state. You have not still moved ahead. So you still have your functional, the running functional cloud as it is for use. No?
Actually, I care about the database. If we address the database.
Database?
And after that, how if we roll back some data in the database?
So database upgrade, you mean by MySQL? Okay, right. So that also happens in steps. So the upgrade process is all defined in the heat template. Every service has a heat template, and it defines a section where the upgrade tasks are defined. The whole thing, see, it's not like you started an upgrade and MySQL got upgraded and then it failed. If it's going to be upgraded, everything will happen at a single parallel, everything will happen as a single unit. Anybody had can guess why the architecture is OpenStack on top of OpenStack? Why you need two clouds? Why you need OpenStack to again create an OpenStack cloud? Okay, so how this architecture came was, a cloud basically needs servers, the compute resources, storage, and networking. So if you are building a cloud, you will need something to manage your compute, manage your networking, and manage your storage. So how this project came into picture was, people thought, why not use the existing services that we know very well and use these services to deploy those services again. So we are using OpenStack, Snowa, Neutron, and Cinder Swift. These three are the main compute, networking, and storage units because we know them very well, because that is what we are going to use in the deployment. So that is how the concept of OpenStack on top of OpenStack came. Any more questions? Yes.
Maybe I think the personal question, but I would like to add that Red Hat already provide the service TripleO, right? And we can buy the OpenStack cloud for telcos and like that. And but in case you said that when we want to upgrade on the system, you need to there will be downtime. But in case I don't want downtime, and I know that currently Cinder or Neutron really implement the rolling upgrades in OpenStack, right? And in TripleO, we can apply the rolling upgrades to the clouds, to the OpenStack. And is there any solution when I don't want to downtime with my service?
I guess there would be a downtime. We can minimize the downtime, but during upgrade, every service has to upgrade, right? Even Neutron has to upgrade. So while Neutron is upgrading, the service will be off. When Neutron is off, there is no networking. You cannot connect. You cannot talk to from one server to the other. So a downtime is at the moment expected. It could be as low as 5 minutes, like I said before, and you can still make it down with containers. You can still reduce it with containers and with having your images pre-uploaded to the local registry. What was your other question? That's all, that answers, right? Okay. Any more? Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. If you have other questions, you know, please do a corner after this as well.